Alright, welcome back. Last time we started the fifth season. We solved, in prior episodes, we solved worlds 1 through 4, which roughly corresponded to spring, summer, winter, and then fall, in that order. And now we're on to season number 5, Mountain. Let's see what we've got. Oh dear, those, you always get a little bit nervous whenever you see sausages or blocks of any sort, pushables, just shoved in the corner like this with no regard to what to do. But thankfully we have a fork. You know, other heroes can only push, but we have the power to pull as well. Well, we could cook all the sausages vertically, or, once again, horizontal may be an option as well. But, for starters, let's just, do the things we know how to do. I mean, that's probably step one. We have found that there are ways of, dealing with this scenario, although it's kind of awkward. Yeah, that's going to be the crux of the whole thing. How do we do this, but also do something sensible afterwards? Because all the ladders are facing north. There's no horizontal-facing ladders in this whole puzzle, right? I sure don't see any. So, I mean, we can do limited amounts of log rolling like this, but we've, I kind of like this puzzle a little bit. A lot of the other puzzles we've seen in this game have just been, something that, you know, you see some obvious obstacles, like the sausages that start up on top of pillars, or far away from the grills, or, like, inside a labyrinth of walls, but these, you know, this is just a common situation where you just have a whole bunch of sausages just stuck in the corner, and they appear impossible to work with, but we'll just be creative, and we'll figure out how to work with them anyway. It might take me some time, but I'll figure something out. So let's just go ahead and restart, because I've barely done anything yet. This is how the puzzle starts out, like this. There's obviously no room to do a direct stab westward or eastward of either of these, that's the whole point. But they start out jammed up like this. Interestingly, I can do a limited degree of log rolling here as well. Like, for example, I could stab this here, unstab this here, go over here, and then extend my bridge down here, so I could go left and right here as much as I wanted. Well, we have our requisite structure over here. I think that's enough to allow us to lose our fork, right? So, I guess we might as well do that. That seems to be the only other, thing we can do at this point. Well, I think I have an idea already. Where does that go? Oh, over there. Well, not really what we want. Let me think about the directions in which I can lose the fork. The fork can be lost westward. That seems to be the easiest way of doing it. I don't see any other ways of doing it. However, we can proceed to push that around, and we can do a little bit of work like that. Hold on. We can do log rolling like this, and you know what? I think I see how that's going to be important. I think I already see the answer. Let me confirm my theory. I don't need to be holding on to a fork to stab with it, you know. Yeah, that's the stuff. And then, we'll log roll it back. But then it's gonna be facing that way, of course, because it's gonna turn over. Yeah, that's a good point. How are we going to fix that? Because if I just log this, roll this over, it's going to be facing that way. Okay, well, I guess I should have seen that coming. I mean, I already knew these facts. It's just I didn't put two and two together. Well... okay, well, can I put that in the middle of the stack, then? Will that work better? Yeah, if, say, I were to do that, does this create a better situation for me? I think it does. Yeah, I should be able to fix that. Yeah, because I think I know that the answer is, yeah. So, instead of doing this... oh, wait a second. Huh? So the little forward tine bends when I do that, so that's not enough force to actually put that in there. I thought log rolling forward would put that in there. Well, anyway, that wasn't actually what I wanted to do anyway. What I wanted to do is this. So, that's the answer. But that's, that was weird. I was not expecting that to be the answer. I mean, when I tried to log roll a... yeah, let me reiterate. I tried to log roll this forward, using no other power but my own, into this fork that was lying to the west, just on the ground. It was braced by this other sausage back here. It was braced by a sausage and not the wall. But that was not enough force to stab onto that. So, I guess, but wait, but it was in the other case, where I had a set of two sausages. I was bracing, like, the front sausage with the power of the back sausage, and that was enough force to impale it on the fork going forward. So it's not just as straightforward as you can't move sausages forward into forks. You have to move the fork into sausages. As we've seen, you can move a sausage into the fork to stab it. It's just that you need some kind of additional bracing power, because merely moving a single sausage into the fork with no back bracing is not enough to do the impaling. You need some other kind of, like you need something to also be moving into the square that the sausage came from in order to do that. I guess that's the rule. Anyway, we're done, right? Just trying to understand the very, very far-reaching consequences of my actions. You know how it is. Well, we'll do the same thing. I want to free that up because I need that space in order to deal with the third sausage, although I could probably log roll it and get basically the same thing, so whatever, I guess, but this makes this easier. Alright. Well, new things were learned, as they are wont to do. That's just how this game works. New elaborations on old mechanics. Let's see, already did that, already did this. I guess we'll do... oh, this looks crowded. That west puzzle looks kind of intimidating. Let's maybe... what's going on here? Well, there's our, requisite plinth. That's blocking the way to something. There's two green sausages. Well, let's take a look. This is very true. It's, you know, it's dour. Is this like a little graveyard that I just kind of stumbled into? Sure, looks like it's some kind of crypt, I guess, but that's very true. And that's just a mystery waiting to be resolved. Because that's what that is. We got our own little stone bridge over here. Alright, well, let's take a look at this puzzle then. Uh-oh. Excuse me, I wish to file a complaint with, the local puzzle director. Where's my grill? Excuse me. Wait. Let's start that puzzle again. Did you hear that crackle? You heard that crackle. There is a grill somewhere in this puzzle. It's somewhere. Well, I have a ridiculous theory that I have absolutely no way of proving is true or false. I think it's that grill way over there. That sounds completely insane and ridiculous, but I nevertheless feel like it's true. I don't know where else a grill would even be. The rest of the island just all sank. But you can still see, like, the froth of, like, where it used to be. But the East Island that's way the heck over there is out of sight. So I have no way of confirming that. I have absolutely no way of confirming that. But nevertheless... Alright, well, enough insane theorizing. I think, I'm gonna need some real meditative tools to figure that one out. I don't even see I would lose my fork or do anything else particularly clever with this one, so I'll leave that one aside for later. That one, with a name like that, that's gonna be, infamous indeed. Let's just take this one aside instead. Alright, there's our grills. Yeah, I certainly prefer puzzles where I can see the grills that I'm working with, that's for sure. Well, not going over here till I lose my fork, that's for sure. If I put, okay, so that's at the same level. It looks a little strange because of the skewedness of the tiles, but that is true. If I log roll a horizontal sausage over here, for example... then I could probably get on another horizontal sausage and go where exactly? I don't know. Yeah, how... Huh. Yeah, how about that? Also... Oh, there's a ladder on this side. Okay, so that means I can go up here and up here. Okay. Alright, so... Losing our fork does seem to be a minor theme of this world. Does appear to be so. I could push, I could push a sausage over, well, if, assuming I had, the ability to push, but, you know, if I did... Let's not put that all the way over quite yet. Let's just put this over here. So, assuming I had the ability to, push east from here, which I don't yet, but assuming I did, then I could move this east twice, put it on the island over there, then shove it one more tile over, and then it would be, up here. And then with a fork, I could, shove it not quite the rest of the way. That would not quite be enough. Because, while I could put another sausage there and then do it again, I would not be able to cook the second sausage the same way. Like, that's how you cook one sausage, but the second sausage... Well, the second sausage you would do by log rolling while disarmed, right? Because you would just log roll that, up onto the grill, but then you'd have to get, like, the other one back somehow, or maybe you'd have to, yeah, there's a lot of options here, and I don't know which one is correct, because I can't log roll the full way over the grills, because then you can't come back, but you could log roll halfway on, like, you could log roll just onto the first set of grills and then back, then dismount over here, then come back. And if you could, I don't know, stab this sausage, then carry it over, then get rid of it, and then roll it over once, you could do it again. So you would only cook the two halves independently and never visit the top half of the grills. That could be an option. I don't know. But yeah, I think this western set of ladders is some sort of help. I don't know what kind of help it is yet, but it's some form of assistance with moving the sausages around. But I think the top island is for losing my fork. Now, how am I going to do a downward stab here? That's a good question. Well, I guess it'll be like this. Yeah, that's the only way I see to do it, but that ought to be good enough, right? I mean, I have to do it that way. Right, so then I mount this, lose my fork, as one does. Well, don't do that yet. Clear the way, so I can have an upward-facing fork. That's just a pushable object. So I can disarm. Doesn't really matter, but I guess there, for the sake of argument. Well, wait a second, I need to be able to... Well, that's what the West Island is for. Okay. Lesson learned. Yeah, of course. When you're on top of a sausage and you're log rolling, you need a way to, recover. However, I can't actually get adjacent to that. Not without the other sausage to help. Okay, fair enough. So, we'll, leave one of these here, then. Okay, so that's an important fact to know about this puzzle. The way it is set up right now, the way it is currently, you need two sausages, both on the west side, in order to recover from losing your fork. Okay, very well then. Well, I guess in that case, I might as well do it over here. Yeah. While I'm lined up, just for the sake of convenience, I'll put it over here. So then we log roll backwards, then we dismount. Now we can do all the work we want while disarmed. So, this is my current running theory. That what you're supposed to do in this puzzle is just half-bake that. Half-cook it. And worry about how to flip that over the other time. If I can manage that, then the rest is just going to be a matter of substitution and shuffling and whatnot, but that should be fairly easy after that, hopefully. So we put that down there. Rearm. And then thus begins the quest to figure out a way to fix this. And I think the most convenient way of fixing this involved, wait a second. Yeah, we never did actually figure out how to fix this, right? No, I don't think we ever did. Alright, so let's review. We did figure out how to make this face north. But that's of limited use unless we can, recover that. Now, we can put this other sausage next to, the first one and maybe come up with some way of using that. I don't know how yet, but maybe. So, for example, I could do something like this. But I don't have anywhere to go after that. Right, so... Yeah, well, hold on. While I'm here, let me just at least just take a quick look around this island. Okay, it's more or less what you would expect. Just your regular 3x3 island with a pillar on top of it. No ladders, no anything else hidden. Just that's all it is. Say, is there a way that I could put the other horizontal sausage on top of this one and then log roll both of us over there? The problem with that is this little tiny pillar over here. That would cause the other horizontal sausage to just rest on the ground instead of coming with me when I did this motion. But at the same time, it's super important because what that does is let me dismount a sausage. Like, if I get on it and do a half log roll, I can go over there and get back off. And that does seem to be relevant. That does seem to be important. Yeah, this one is mysterious, but it's the good kind of mysterious. There's a lot of avenues of exploration, and yet everything still seems to make sense. Everything's kind of compartmentalized, you know? There's still, everything is still kind of close together, but this is made of, like, separate components, I guess. Each of the components feels separate at the moment, although I am still kind of eyeing the specific distances from one to the other, lessons from cold frustration at play here. But it's just, I've been given a lot of tools. I'm just trying to figure out how to get the best use out of the tools, that's all. So, yeah, I'm just trying to come to grips with this situation I've created here is all. So either there's an easier, better way of cooking the sausages, or there's some way to survive this scenario, which doesn't seem particularly likely. If I were facing the other way, if I were facing a vertical direction, then what I could do is lose my fork, and then potentially work with that. However, still seems unlikely. Also, I should also note that the starting position, and thus the end position, is facing south. That's probably not too relevant in this particular case, but it does narrow down the circumstances. As I saw in the other few couple of levels. You can finish a level if you have your sausage stabbed in, like, a fork stabbed into a sausage, but if you're permanently stabbed into a sausage that you can't unsheath from, unstab from, then, facing horizontal would obviously be a huge obstacle to going vertically, and there would be that pillar in the way of being able to actually step on this square anyway. So, clearly we're not meant to end this level with a horizontal stabbed sausage into my fork to the east. That's not on the menu for today. So let's review. I think this is the right first step. I think I was on the right track with just getting things started with this, with losing the fork. I just don't know, I'm just not quite sure yet how that actually plays into things, because I'm not sure if this half-cooking hypothesis that I'm working with here is actually the correct method of proceeding. However, we might as well at least put our tools in front of us and see what we can work with. Now, a new thought, of course, occurs to me. In this puzzle, it's possible to put our fork on top of a sausage. I don't see any obvious way in which that helps, but it is there. So, for example, we could do something really silly like this. Just drop that on the west side there, shove this over, and now we can be armed while we go and do this stuff. And in fact, the island is also convenient enough that we can actually exit while we're like that, because, right, because this is another one-way passageway. So we can get off while doing that, which is very interesting. However, it doesn't necessarily solve our problems. Is there any way I could be carrying another sausage while I'm doing this, though? Oh, now that's an interesting idea. Because if I'm carrying a sausage, I could unhook it using this island, dump it over here, and then log roll the other way back, and that would solve my problem. Could I do that? I don't know. Yeah, that's a good question. Is that possible? Wait, how did I do that? I backed next to the fork, so I didn't automatically pick it up yet. So, of course that's not going to, that's not going to take my fork with me, because... I think it's purely and simply because the fork is a thing that's resting on this, whereas I'm the one who's actually moving it, so that... Yeah, this is basically the same as if I were pushing it from the bottom, like pushing it on the same Y level instead of log rolling it. There's no reason the physics have changed just because I'm log rolling instead of pushing. It's the same motion. So, of course, the fork is just going to roll off the top, of course. Right. So I have a nice theory, but the implementation still leaves something to be desired. Yeah, how would I take another sausage with me? Ideally, I guess it would have to be embedded in this fork. Yeah, because if it were embedded in this fork, and on top of this, then I would basically pick up the sausage. Then I would be carrying it with me while I was doing the log rolling. Then I'd strafe over there, unsheath it, and do all of that. So how do I get a sausage embedded into that fork? And on top of there. I think that's the answer. If I can do that, I think this puzzle is solved. I think. But that's still a bit of a tall order. Well... Okay, let's leave that there for the time being. I still don't know how I'm going to... I still have to be able to dismount, because my prior observation has not gone away. I still have to be able to start in this position in order to lose the fork in the first place. Like, that has not stopped being true. But then there's no way of elevating either of these sausages without the fork in the first place. Huh. Well... Is there a way of log rolling in a different fashion that doesn't cause me to lose my fork immediately on top of the cliff? Can I lose my fork somewhere else instead? Only with proper preparation, I think. That, well, I mean, the only way that that I would lose it like this is if I had, like, a too tall stack of sausages, and I'd just wind up on top of that anyhow. Well... If I had another sausage on top of that... well, okay. I'm still not sure how this... I'm having trouble visualizing what exactly I want to do at this point, but... Let me just at least experiment a little bit. I can put both sausages on top of, on top of this island. Well, if I do it properly, that is. So... I guess I might as well. I mean, you can do things like this, but they don't help. Yeah, that's, interesting, but also not gonna go anywhere. Could I, like, unhook one of these over here, and then, like, put it up there or something? Maybe. So before I bring that up there, leaving that on the west side, I'll shove this up here for safekeeping. then I'll bring the next sausage up. That's not really an ideal amount of room to work with, though. It's kind of awkward. If I were facing the other way, perhaps that might be better. I'm not sure yet, though. Also interesting to notice the ladder is placed where it is. It is on this second column here, in alignment with this column, but also right here instead of right here. So I can't carry this kind of upward stab like up the island like around the corner. Like we have been able to do that in some other puzzles, but you can't do that in this one. Not this time. The only other place I can see to lose a fork would be on top of that island over there. Like, if I did, well, it'd have to look something like... Oops. Yeah, like, if I could face this way while rotating, downwards, then I could make that happen. And there's... If I could log roll... like, if I somehow manage to get both of them stacked, horizontally like this, I could log roll, facing downwards, and I could lose my fork on top of that. The problem with that, of course, is that after I was done with that, I'd have two sausages over here, and I'd have nowhere to go other than over here, and that would be the ladder clog to end all ladder clogs. There would be... Not a heck of a lot I could do after that, but I could put my fork on top of this island. That is a way I could do it. It forms a neat challenge, but it's not the correct way of solving this puzzle, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. I'm just noting it for completeness' sake as a way I can drop the fork facing south on somewhere that's not this top cliff here. Then again, I don't think a south-facing fork is necessarily all that helpful. For what I want to accomplish here. So yeah, just to restate my goal, just to say it again out loud in full view. I want to put a horizontal sausage here on the bottom. I want to put another horizontal sausage on top of it with my fork embedded in it facing north. So far, the only way I've found to drop my fork facing north is to log roll off of this cliff while facing north, thus dropping the fork. However, it appears that in order to do that, I would have, like, in order to, at some point, the intermediate steps would involve having my fork on top of this cliff while both of these are on the lower level. And then figuring out some way to elevate one of these regardless. Well... Okay, another option is coming into mind. Like, I could drop my first ladder, like my first log roll in this column, log roll down here, and I could step on a horizontal sausage over here and get onto this island. This is an incredibly awkward place to put this sausage, but it is an option. I really don't like the way that that looks, but I'll try it anyway, just because it's new. Because, like, then you just create the same exact problems of, like, how do you get this back out. There is no convenient way of doing that other than that. But I'm willing to give it a try nonetheless. Well, okay, well, there's an immediate problem. I can't actually mount that to, go off of there. Right? Well, no, of course I can. I can just do that. And then, log roll a little bit further. So this kind of thing is possible. and it lends another further use to that place. Now, well, now I've just royally messed things up now, haven't I? Well, it was a nice thought. But it does mean that I can log roll off the west side with under similar circumstances. Well, for example, what that would mean is that I can log roll off the westmost column. And with the proper setup, you can do log rolling like that, which is very questionably physicsable, but it works in this universe. It works in this universe, so I can do things like that. Just drop that right off like that. Or, I mean, I can drop it off the cliff like that, but that's not much better than what I was already doing. It means I only need a single sausage in order to do this part, though. Yeah, that's a good discovery. That is a good discovery. So that means I'm free to put the other one wherever I want. I'm sure I can make some use of that. So what does that mean? I can log roll off, I can get the fork up there, I can put it over there. How do I get a sausage at Y level number 2 with the fork embedded into it? The obvious seeming answer would be to transport the fork somewhere else. Put it on, maybe put it on this island, maybe put it on somewhere else. There's not a whole lot of features at Y level 2. Well, I guess you could call this 1 or 0, I'm not sure. Indexing is kind of hard to do in this game, but just one Y level above the start, I guess you could say. So, the fork has to be at rest at that level, and a sausage has to move into it, I think. Because there's no way I can lose my fork at that level, is there? I can't really lose it over here. I certainly haven't found a way to lose it over there. Like, the ways I've found of losing my fork involve, like, falling really far. And, all the ways I've found of falling really far involve me standing on top of a sausage. So, at the very least, the lowest I can be while standing on top of a sausage is at Y1. So all my fork-losing spots are at Y2, namely this island, on top of that cliff, and on top of that pillar, sure, why not? I don't see how that one's going to come into play, but who knows with this game. Yeah, that, I think I can safely rule that one out, just because there's no way to climb up over there. So I don't think I'm getting my fork back if I put it on top of there as an ornament. So, what does that mean? I think that means I have to move the fork somewhere else after that, though. Because I can certainly push it around. I found ways of getting it to other places. But how do I get the sausage into it? Is the question. I guess I have to pre-elevate one of these things. And deposit it somewhere else. I'm not sure yet how I want to do that, but... Well, let's experiment, I suppose. I know how I can achieve a stack of 2 sausages. I've already done that. I'm just trying to figure out where that would come in handy. Where do I want to put a sausage that's elevated? I can put it nearly anywhere I want. Not quite anywhere, but pretty close. Well, Well, that's not quite as good. I could also put it on top of this island. It would be blocking the way, like I couldn't get back up to it, but there might still be ways of, with log rolling especially, to dislodge it anyway. Although the only place I could actually put it would be down here, which is not very attractive. But if I have my fork, it's not lost if I put it down here. Like, if I have a horizontal sausage on this row, and I have my fork, I can still get it back. So that is potentially helpful. The problem is the... Like, let's just assume for the sake of argument that I have a sausage up here. Up here. How would I get a fork into it? And even if I did get a fork into it, the only logical place I could see to maybe put it would be... over here would be the straightest option. Although, if I made a perfect stack, I could push the whole thing up here and then over there. As we've seen, vertical stacks like these, you can move both vertically and horizontally pretty easily. So, assuming that I already had the fork stabbed into this somehow. And I was disarmed. Then I could, if I form that formation anywhere else in the level... that is, horizontal down there, another horizontal up there with the fork already in it. And I form that anywhere, almost anywhere in this level that I can push it at least. Then I can, even without a fork, I can push it both horizontally and vertically into the spot that I need it at. So I definitely don't need to form it over here. I need to form it somewhere else where it's, more easily accessible. I'm just having the darndest time figuring out how you actually do it. Well, yeah, that's a good question. I don't have very much room down here. If I had a little bit more room, I could maybe see something work with, this sausage already being perched up here, and then something else, but, yeah, it seems hard. I mean, I guess you could perch it over here, but then I still don't know what you would do after that either. Yeah, so it seems like both the, either the fork has to be resting on terrain at Y2, and the second sausage, the one that's also at Y2, has to be on top of the Y1 sausage, and you move it in that way. Like, let's say I have a sausage facing horizontal here, another sausage facing horizontal up here. And then I have, like, a fork up there. That's obviously not gonna work. Or I could have the sausage laying on solid ground and maybe hanging over the edge a little bit, and then I have a sausage at Y0 with a, or Y1. I don't know. I have to just pick one. I guess we'll call this Y1. We'll one-index things, just to be different. So I have a horizontal sausage at Y1, a fork... north-facing fork on top of it at Y2, and a vertical, and another second horizontal sausage at Y2. So then we move the fork, the sausage, the fork goes with it, and then, I don't know if that's enough force to stab into the upward sausage, though. Like, the game might just tell me, hey, that's not enough force, your fork is just gonna kind of brush against it lightly and then fall to the ground. And that is a question I'd have to answer in another puzzle. In a situation where that's easier to set up. I kind of get the opinion that, yeah, now that I have a question that I want to answer at another puzzle, that may be relevant to how you solve this one, I think that's probably it. I think I probably just want to check out another one and then come back. Because so far, I certainly haven't done anything here that's hard to replicate, for sure. But, interesting questions. All from inquiries. Inquiries lead to further inquiries. Questions beget questions.